So you created your awesome reel and you export it, you use Google Drive or you airdrop it to your phone to not lose the quality whatsoever. And on your phone, it looks amazing. And when you upload to Instagram, immediately it looks pixelated. It looks horrible and you instantly want to remove it. So in this one, I'm going to share with you my export settings that I use for each of my reels to get the best possible quality and to avoid compression from the IG side, because like IG loves to compress the shit out of your footage. So let's jump into Premiere and I will show you what you need to do. Let's go. So we're inside Premiere and first thing that we need to do is we need to create a sequence, and from here choose DSLR 1080p 1080p 24 and go to the settings. From this drop down you can change your frame rate if it's something different than 24 fps, but mine is 24. I will leave it as is. And frame size, change it 1080 1920, so it will give us the 9:16 aspect ratio, and that's what we needed. And rest, leave it as is, and click save preset and just name it and click OK, and it will save you the preset and you'll not going to mess up with the settings anymore. But I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to click OK and our sequence is ready. And you can see like our video is basically vertical and our sequence is horizontal. And when I'm going to drag and drop this here, it will say that clip doesn't match sequence settings. I'm gonna say keep existing settings so our sequence will not change. And let's assume that we're ready with our reel and we need to export it. So you can press Ctrl M or you can go to the export. So from here, you should go with match source adaptive high bitrate for the preset. This is good start. So file name, just name it whatever and choose the location where you want to save the file. So format H.264, this is good, leave it as is. Go to the video settings, check your frame rate, it should be 1080 by 1920. So if there is something wrong, just click on match source and it will correct the mistakes. Go to the more and click on the render at maximum depth and use maximum render quality. So for the performance, there is hardware encoding and there is software encoding. On some machines, it will be software encoding only. And on machines with GPU, it will be hardware encoding. So basically your GPU will kick in and will render it for you. If you have the hardware encoding option, you should go with it. Untick this and go to the high, the profile settings. Level, you should go with 5.1, basically. The rest is looking good in here. And basically, the most important settings is the bitrate settings. And there is three options for you. It's the constant bitrate, so basically, if we're going to choose like, I don't know, 16, it will be 16 megabits per second throughout our video. But for this particular case, we're going to go with VBR, and VBR stands for variable bitrate. And what it is, if you have something complex in your scene, it will kick in and add bitrates to that frame specifically. And if you have something static, it will be lower bitrates at that point. And the sweet spot for this is 10 to 16. So I will go with 16. And you can see the estimated file size is only 20 megabytes. So this is just a small file size and Instagram compression will not kick in and will not screw up your video. And the higher this number, you can see the estimated file size is larger, so you should stick with 16. And for me, this works perfect. And the rest, just leave it as is. And you can also like create a preset for yourself. Click on these three dots here, click on save preset, just name it, and you will have it in your preset list. For example, I don't know, 4K high quality export for YouTube. I have that. And next time you're on this page, you're just going to choose your preset and you're going to click export, or you're going to click send to media encoder. And basically this is it.
So now you know how to create best possible quality Instagram reels and avoid the compression. So go and create, and I'm out.